beside themselves with passion, some of them would not be backward even about scheming to suppress and silence their adversaries. And I love this ironic last bit. I have had some experience of this myself. Boy, did he. Boy, did he.
And, you know, we can look to our own day and age, the causes of climate change, the existence of climate change. So, you know, let's see if we can get your jaw working a little less. Perfectly cool. You know, let's see if we can kind of calm this down a little bit. But that's very different from your jaw shouldn't move. Singing is just like speaking. Do I speak at those volumes and those pitches? No.
Isn't that what the French school argues?
Yeah. A lot of that, you know. Well, and we have the, you know, si parla si canta kind of thing. I think they're getting at the clarity of articulation. I don't know. There's no need for vowel modification. Just sing E and give it more space. So if we give it more space, is it
vowel modification?
It's vowel modification. I mean, I have heard every single one of these statements. Because I used to accompany voice lessons as undergraduate. Okay, so here's Mirella Franey. God bless her. Sound great? You bet it sounds great. I mean, this is a legendary recording, you know? And she was a legendary Mimi. Did she think about it probably in those terms? Nah. It's okay. Or, I want pure vowels. I think what most people say when they say, I want pure vowels, is not that they want speech-like, unmodified vowels. It's that they don't want the consonants creeping in, you know, too soon or lingering on the consonant. I think that's what they mean. Because often if I push people on that and I'll question that, they go, right, I don't want that L coming in. Okay, then let's call it that. So often what we depend on the consonants to judge what vowel, because we're hearing it in a context. Okay, so listen to this. Vowel would you say?
It's like bad.
Do you hear a little bit of mixed in too? Okay. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hit it that last time. Okay, now. Do you hear a little more A in that one?
Yeah.
But still there's kind of that mixed in to the A. Uh-huh. Okay, now let's put the consonants back in.
That was per te, wasn't it?
It's per te, but it ends up being per-te. Yeah, he's shading in a mixed vowel, and you could watch him. I've got a video of him singing this aria, and he's very definitely puckered, and yet his tongue is very much in the front vowel position. So yeah, you get kind of a mixed color. So that ain't no pure A vowel. Yeah, this sits right in your brain. Y'all have probably heard my sermon about the break. I don't like the break.
Mutation.
I don't like the break. I don't like the break at all. Okay, it's right in your passaggio. Okay, I'll take that one. Anything's better than break. I'm giving you this piece which sits on your break to work your passaggio.
Break is just such a negative, sad word.
Isn't it? Yeah, so I'm going to give you this piece that's in that bad spot so that we can work on this, and I'm going to have you sing it in public.
Well, why would you tell a student that? I mean, why would you tell them the reason for the piece anyway? If not just an intimidation.
Yeah, well, you know, my favorite one of these is Smanyem Plakami.
No.
E flat, E flat, E flat, E flat, E flat, E flat.
So awful.
better fix it now. It's like, here's the bar, get over. Oh well. We've already talked about that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, just be accurate. You know, this is my plea for accuracy and thinking about the language that we use, which goes back to the very beginning of that fall class. Connotations of words that could be negative. Pressure, break, and catch up. I had a question today from a very good singing teacher and speech pathologist saying, well, what are your real essential pedagogy books that have been written in the last 20 years? Well, I know there's a whole bunch that I've really not even looked at yet. Because, you know, I spend a lot of my time, if I'm reading things, it's research articles. And writing things myself. And, you know, friends of mine put a book out or something like that, I'll get a copy and I'll read it. Okay, great, yeah, cool, that's a good one. You know, and it goes on my shelf. But staying current is so important. And that's why going to conferences, watch other people teach, reading the Journal of Singing, reading other things, finding out what's going on. I mean, 20 years ago, the whole business with using straws, no one in singing was doing that. Nobody. 20 years ago, Voce Vista was just coming into being because you finally had affordable, you know, desktop computers. And nowadays, those things are really, really used a lot. Any question? Oops, that was an old survey. So, I talked to Dorothy, and she's okay on the idea of, you know, having a gathering. I said, you know, Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Oh, what's that about? And I thought, in my ear, a little voice said, a virgin.
We shall sacrifice it.
That's like, you know, somebody who's never gone to Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. That's another one. Oh gosh, how many times have I seen that movie? Well, anyway, so we'll just...
Seeing it live and seeing it are different. Like,
oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, going to a theater and being a part of the event.
That is
a trip.
So Dorothy, you're gonna hear this. You're gonna hear this, Dorothy. Yeah. So we're going to corrupt you.
No.
Okay. So.